Hi there, Eric Bakker, naturopath. Thanks for coming back. We're talking about mold, mold toxicity, mold signs and symptoms, mold detection, what to do for mold, etc. So we're going to talk today about the different types of molds that can affect you and mycotoxins. So there are basically, I think, thousands of different types of molds that can live in your house. I think it's so far, they're currently up to around 14,000 or 15,000, they're sort of determined. So there are many different types of molds that live in the air, that sit on surfaces, just like there are bacteria. They are ubiquitous, they're everywhere. You can't live in a sterile environment, and you don't want to live in a sterile environment because your body is full of bacteria, you know, and there are various species of mold that live inside the body and onside the body, and they're there by default. It's only when we get a huge, big imbalance and an immune dysfunction that we allow certain species to get the upper hand and make us sick. So in New Zealand particularly, we have one quite common called Aspergillus, and there are hundreds of Aspergillus species. But Aspergillus commonly affects people here with lung problem and the sinus problem, and we've seen it a lot here with people with leaky buildings. So another one which is a little bit less common but probably even more powerful than Aspergillus is called Stachybotrys. S-T-A-C-Y-B-O-T-R-Y-S, Stachybotrytis, some people call it. This is actually a black or grey sort of greeny mold. It's quite common. We see it regularly too on walls and surfaces inside houses. This one I've seen quite commonly in the news. It was reported when people had cladding put on their houses. It was basically a styrofoam cladding, and then the roof wasn't put on properly, and then water was leaking in between, you know, the roof and the wall, creating a lot of problems for people. And this was Stachybotrys was the main mold in this particular case. You may have heard of one called Penicillium. Penicillium actually grows quite commonly on bread. You'll see that green sort of layer of penicillium growing on bread. And my mom used to say to me, eat it, scrape it off and eat it. It's free antibiotics. Well, she was Jewish after all. So Aspergillus we've spoken about, Stachybotrys, Penicillium. Penicillium, you do see, but it's not quite as common as the other two I mentioned. And other two, which I think you find more in the northern hemisphere, Alternaria, I think this one's called. Alternaria, I think that's a North American one. And Cladosporium we see quite a lot as well in the temperate regions. So those are the five different types of mold that we will commonly see in people or in their environment. And the mycotoxins we look at is one called aflatoxin, which you may be familiar with peanuts. So that's a blue-green mold. This is why I don't like peanuts much as a food. They grow underground, they're a legume, they're not a nut, they're not really a tree nut. They're not a great food to eat in general, even for healthy people in my opinion. So aflatoxin can create a lot of liver toxicity with people, can make people very sick. And there's one called ochratoxin, which is quite similar to the aflatoxin. I think the colour's a bit different. Trichothecenes. So this is one I've not really heard of. Again, this will probably be, I would say, one found more in Europe or America. Could well be down here. I may need to do a bit more research on that one. But I know aflatoxin, and I've heard of the ochratoxin. So trichothecenes is a different one. So yeah, but I'm sure there's hundreds of other species that I haven't even mentioned that cause a problem with people. But remember, you can also get functional medicine tests done, which can even determine your sensitivity to different types of molds out there. Some tests offer that up to 100 or even 200 species where they can detect if you've got a problem within your body. So if in doubt, talk to your doctor, functional medicine doctor, not your medical doctor, because they don't generally have much interest in mold toxicity of people, apart from using nasal sprays and things like that, you know, steroids or antihistamines. You're better off going to your naturopathic doctor or functional medicine doctor for detection. Thanks for tuning in. I appreciate it.